is D.P. Reddy. I am President of Telangana Development Forum, India. As you know, most of you know, Telangana Development Forum is an NRI organization spread from America to Australia, almost 30 countries. Actually, first I want to say condolence to the bereaved family, and I pray God to keep the soul of the Sarvottam Rao Garu in peace. Actually, my NRIs, Sarvottam Rao Garu gave very good messages. Because he was interacting, I just know, Ved Kumar Gabra also telling me. He was replying. He was always responding to our mails. He was a member of our Telangana Development Church of groups. All NRIs, they participated. Almost around 5,000 people. Yes, I want to tell his words. In his words only, I want to tell you what he told. Particularly on history, vision, Mulki rules, irrigation. And also another last point is, and I think you all know, there was a controversy Lagadapati raised in as parliament regarding Nehru's declaration, Nizamabad declaration. That means Karnataka ladki, that point. But that also I will tell you how Janardhan Rao Garu, Sarvottam Rao Garu and XMP Narayan Reddy Garu came forward and told us we will go to Delhi and present the case. Yes, I want to tell his words for his replies to Lagadapati letter to Sri Krishna Committee. Samai Kendra has 3,000 years history. But that Sarvottam Rao Garu, this is regarding history. He mentioned, Telangana was a Suba province under the Bahamani Sultan. The headquarters was Kodangal in 1495 AD. The Subedar was Kuli Shah, who declared independence in 1512 AD. Shifted capital to Golconda and founded the Qutub Shahi dynasty. Telangana was a separate Suba under the Mughal Empire, Emperor Shah Jahan, from 1636. South of Krishna River, the territory was under Bijapur Sultan, Sultans, and later under Haider Ali and his son Tipu Sultan. This territory is known as Deccan, Karnataka in the Mughal records. From 1299 AD, Telangana has a distinct political identity in history of Deccan. See Sarvottam Rao. Regarding history, he challenged, he contradicted Lagadapati. Regarding vision, myopic vision of Telangana movement leaders, he addressed to us, you are very correct, there must be a strategy to carry on an agitation. We must provide a Telangana vision document, TDF, and we have prepared a document as per his advice. At every stage, an alternative method must be thought in case of any difficulties. A plan of action must be prepared in consultation with all stakeholders and implemented accordingly. I have been a student of Allahabad University and of the Students' Union during 1947-49. I didn't know I was a student of Allahabad University. Jai Telangana. This is about vision, Telangana vision document. About Mulki rules, what we are talking now, Nativity. This was in 2000. He was writing to us, to our groups, since 2008 until 2013 end. Dear Reddy Garu, in the Mulki rules, it was necessary to get two witnesses to depose before the district collector about the candidate being a Mulki. Both witnesses were to be born Mulkis or government servants. Another informal condition was that the father of the applicant had to be a Mulki, born or residing for over 15 years. This solved many problems. I think KCR Garu is implementing the same 1956 Nativity. Sarvottam Rao Garu wrote, I think, 2010, this mail to us. He was fond of, as a forest officer, he was fond of environment. Hyderabad may get dehydrated to an ICU level. Planting suitable healthy seedlings, suitable site after the rains have set in, is approved forestry plantation practice. No watering is done in the forest. The rains in the month of August, September are enough for growth of plants. Planting of seedlings after the month of July, August is not correct. We are doing that now. Anyhow, we are not getting rains as predicted. Plants grow as per natural laws. Planting any spaces, anywhere, any time of year results in failure. Plant seedlings after the onset of rains, after soil is fully wet and allow about 2-3 months of rains for getting good results. As one needs a civil engineer to construct a house, University of Forest to raise plantations, Sarvottam Rao. This is about the environment. Now about irrigation. This is the actual TRC charcha, you know, the Vedakumar Garu conducting every week. This was regarding 21st March 2012. TRC charcha invitation Telangana. Telangana lo vidyut paristhiti and raitula samasyalu. But that he replied. The solution to Telangana problems is only through a small water bodies, cherus and kuntas. The land area of Telangana is, he gave complete details. 46,000 square miles, 150,000 square kilometers, more than half the land area is upland with elevation of over 1,000 feet, 666 meters. From century to century, farmers with the help of kings constructed in each watershed a number of small kuntas, one below the other, from the ridge to valley, a number of kuntas, plants under which even areas 2 to 5 acres were cultivated. In the valley, you have big tanks, thousands of acres are under cultivation, Ganpur, Ramappa, etc. Till 1950, after Andhra government came, till 1956 there existed about 1,20,000 such kuntas under which over 12 lakh acres were under cultivation. Due to continued neglect of government, these kuntas have been encroached and damaged all these years. That is, we are reviving now, new government. By 2001-2, about 7 lakh acres went out of cultivation, leaving only about 5 lakh acres for cultivation. The economic, ecological and social loss to the region is immense. The loss of cash flow is more than 7,000 crores per year. Total cultivable area in Telangana is 127 million acres, of which more than half area is about 14 million acres is uplands. Most of Telangana is grey area for groundwater. Agriculture is under bore wells. Is a bane and not a boon to the Telangana farmer. I have prepared a sketch map not to scale, showing these physical features of this region, taking inputs from various irrigation engineers. This can be taken from me in case you consider it useful for that. So he was giving his Nallakunta address and telephone numbers also. And yes, I will finish this Islamabad declaration. Actually, Sushma Swaraj told about Indian Express 6th March 1956 statement. Somehow this TDF tried to locate this in Deccan Chronicle, and we are sent to people to Madras and also Delhi Museum and Nehru Museum, but we didn't get. But at that time, Narayan Reddy Garu and Sarvottam Rao Garu, Sarvottam Garu told us, we was present in that meeting declaration, Islamabad declaration called Nehru's declaration. I'm reading for your knowledge. On 5th March 1956, Jawaharlal Nehru declared at Nizamabad, Telangana, that the government of India decided to merge Telangana with Andhra. He also assured to Telangana people that a masoom ladki, bachi Telangana ek natkat Andhra ke saath shadi ho raha hai. Kai din ke baad mein ittefaq nahi hone ke wajah se talaq de sakte hain. An innocent girl Telangana is married to a delinquent Andhra. If they are not interested, they could seek separation at a later date. This was published in Indian Express 6th March 1956, but we could not get to the Andhras. They have removed it from the archives and everywhere. For this, Sarvottam Rao Garu openly came and said, we will come early and give the press statement. Thank you.